Okay, so here we've got a 314. So it's a Sapele back and sides, gloss Sitka spruce top. With all our naming conventions, basically if you have a lettering, it's a non-cutaway. If you have lettering, so 14, 15, 16, that would be a cutaway. Now, there's many things on these guitars that are really unique to Taylor. One is the NT neck, which is a bolt-on neck. You have spaces in here, which basically you can set the neck and the angle, angle of the neck rather, and that can be done in 15, 20, 30 minutes maximum, rather than, you know, maybe a couple of weeks job with the glue-on neck. We've also got the expression system in here. So actually this is a system where it's not like a piazzo, where it's sitting under the saddle. We're only picking up the strings and the sound of the strings. Actually what you're doing is there's a sensor here and here, and you're picking up the vibration of the top of the guitar. You're actually picking up the dynamics of the player as well. You have an under sort of fretboard pickup here, which is a samarium cobalt single coil, and that's just picking up the string sensor. So that one's always on. Actually you can have some little switches inside here, which you can just get to with your little finger, and that'll switch either one of these two pickups on or off. So again, there's another tone option for you. If you need it to sound just a little bit less so, you can switch both off or just have one or either on or off. And again, that'll just give you a different tone option. So again, very simple, volume, bass and treble. There's a preamp here that was designed by Rupert Neve. There's an audio legend, you know, Beatles recorded all their stuff on his preamps. So you've got a studio grade preamp in there. All of the wiring in here is Molex connected, so there's no soldering involved, so it's very easy to get in and out if need be. There's also a few string ground in here, so basically if you get a spark from a mic, there's a fuse in there that will blow, could potentially save your life. So it's very unique to Taylor's. So all of that is very unique to what Taylor are doing. It's all about picking up the dynamics of the player and the dynamics of what the top is doing. So here you can see what's under the hood a little bit. You can see where the body sensors are sitting. You can see the preamp here, you see the 9-volt system, and you can also see that fused string ground. So the body sensors, basically a little magnet inside some ferrite oil, inside a cup, with the sonic welded top on it, and then we stick that to the top. And those are the ones that are picking up the vibrations of the top. Here you've got the preamp, that's the one that we talked about being designed by Rupert Neve, so studio grade preamp. Here you can see those little buttons, or little switches. So those are the ones that switch the two body sensors on and off. Here you can see a dummy coil, so that's hum cancelling. Under here, that's where the samarium cobalt single coil is, picking up the strings. There's actually one pole piece missing in that single coil pickup. And what we've done is we've taken that out and actually put it inside the neck. And what that does is, it helps balance all the strings a lot better. Because basically your B string is your hottest string. It's much hotter even than the G string, because the G string is wound. So a B string has the most steel content. So basically that means that all your strings are balanced and you don't have any problems with out of balance volumes on any of your strings. Again, this fuse here on this fuse string ground just pops in and out, there's no soldering. So again, get that spark, it will basically save your life, or save, you know, one of your customers' lives if they get a fatal amount of voltage going through. There used to be a 3-volt system on these, but we changed to a 9-volt. They came in around 2006. Everyone knows what a 9-volt is. It's really easy. Guitarists put in their pedals. Really easy to get hold of. So, you know, a little bit more headroom in there as well. So, really, that's our expression system. Very easy to fix if it need be. It's all Molex connectors, as we said. So, it just pops in and out. You can literally pull those through the sound hole and fix those within minutes. So, again, it's about innovation. So about making it easy for people to get back on the roads and get their guitars back quickly. Okay, so we have the bracings here. So this is a forward shifted X bracing system. X bracing is pretty much on most guitars. We've actually shifted this forward because it helped. It's part of how we make the sound of a Taylor, is that it just shifts that forward and helps that whole top to move a little more. The scalloped brace, so that's literally sitting down, scalloping out, listening, hearing what sounds good, what doesn't sound good. And then we find something that really works, and that's how we get our scalloped bracing. Really, scalloped bracing is about how it affects the bass and treble and mid-range responses, and how it helps that top move in and out. You know, is it making it too stiff, or is it making it too loose? And all those factors contribute to how that top will move, and how that top will, and the guitar will sound. So this is the NT neck, or new technology neck. Again, we've talked about it being bolt-on. It's a very stable neck. Again, you can set the angle of the neck for lifetime of the guitar. So at any point, if you've got a problem with your neck, you can just have that repaired very easily and very quickly. You've got a scarf joint here. So we used to do a finger joint, which looks a little bit like that, without the pick in there. So on solid neck, that'll break at about 100 pounds of pressure. On a finger joint, which is the one I've just shown you, that'll break at about 150 pounds of pressure. If you've got a scarf joint like this, that breaks at 200 pounds of pressure. So as you can see, it's a very stable, very strong neck. You very rarely hear of a twisted tailor neck, just because of the way we mill them. It's all computer aided and computer milled. So, you know, very strong, very stable. So if I just take this neck off, again, there are actually three bolts on this. There's only one bolt on this one, just for the purposes of me being able to get it off a little bit quicker. Can I just give you that bolt? Thanks. So, as you can see, there's a bolt here, it's a 3/16 Allen key, and then here, 7/16, two bolts. Literally just comes off. So here you can see how we do our spacer system. This whole guitar is finished first, and then we cut this pocket out, and there's two spacers. There's one in the heel, one in the extension here. Basically it's like a fulcrum system, so the neck will actually rock on this here, and the actual change in size happens on this end and this end. So actually you'll see that neck moving in and out, and it's in 2/1000 of an inch increments these are milled in. This is a piece of Sapele, it's very hard, it's very stable. And that's how we get a very stable neck, and that's why it's so easy, because we can just choose from, it goes from 0 to plus 20 or 0 to minus 20 around there. It might be a little bit more now, but those are basically the tolerances that we work within. You wouldn't really be able, it's like the thickness of a paper card is the difference between the sizes. So it's very small, but it makes a big difference as to how that neck angle sits and how it works.